Hey, pretty fish. It is the 9th of June, 6/9/2018. And I was just coming out to do some reading here this morning and was hitting a random Bible verse to get a start, you know. And when I hit this chapter, book, and verse right here, a lot of things came falling into place concerning the 3, 6, 9 and all of this crazy stuff that I've been seeing. All right. And it goes kind of back to the last couple of days, some articles and stuff that I've seen. Okay. And this was yesterday, and I knew that there was something to this, but upon further observation, really, this place called CrossFit, right? It's a gym, and they were having this event for the Pride people, and they canceled it. So one of their employees was happy about that because he considered it a sin. And so they fired him. Okay? Truth is a lie, lie is a truth, up is down. You know, that's just where we're at. But I noticed the name, CrossFit, Cross. Okay? Just craziest stuff. And look at this sign. CrossFit Infiltrate. And they got these little hexagon-shaped cells here, like a beehive, you know? Six-sided. 666. CrossFit Infiltrate. So, you know, I'm just led there. So most people know that cross itself in the English is 444 rather. Okay, so I put CrossFit Infiltrate. Now check this out. This is pretty wild. These are some pretty crazy numbers, to be honest with you. 322, the 13, the 11, the rebellion, the chaos. I mean, just all this crazy stuff, right? So that just comes from this article right here, which is crazy. The world has, you know, officially gone insane. And this reminded me once again of another article that I had saved from a few days ago right here. And the reason that I saved it was because when we were looking at the stuff about the Israeli Times Square event, well, this event right here was just a couple hours after the mayor of New York was trying to push through a new law for an X category that would add a third gender to birth certificates, which is doubly insane. This is 100% delusional thinking by these people. And much of it is, if not all of it actually, is completely by design. You're watching the flipping of humanity, okay? You're literally witnessing that fleshly spirit, the spirit of Satan, lust and greed and pride coming into the natural world, and this is the result, that they're doing insane things like that, okay? So it reminded me of that as a few hours later, he is leading the parade. The march was led by Mayor de Blasio, who earlier in the day was pushing for a third gender, and the Jewish community obviously is supporting that because they support him. So I'm just seeing a lot of hypocrisy, like really deep on the part of the Jewish people. And I don't know why, it's just leading me towards, you know, pointing out the fact that the Jewish leadership, you know, not the Israelis, not my brethren. I mean, the real Jews, are you kidding me? Those are my bros. But these people are the Jews who say they're Jews, but they're not. They lie, okay? The leadership, that's who you gotta look at, right? Because they just support each other on every angle, including this type of behavior, which is off the hook insanity. That's what it is, okay? So I could start throwing around some different things, but what this here reminded me of was the X phone, the iPhone, remember that? And I found my way back to that through another article right here. This was yesterday. Okay, and I promise I'll remember to put the links. IBM, the United States, America, has the best supercomputer for the time being, that is. Because this thing will just be obsolete in probably 6 months. But who cares? They're not even using these for the real work anyway. This is just to keep the lie going, because they're using D-Wave qubit technology that can, one machine can do 10 times what this whole room does, okay? Remember Gordy Rose? I mean, I can bring this stuff up if you guys want, because it's very relevant. Remember this guy? Because what he says is absolute truth. And I'm going to link this video, because what he's telling you is absolute truth. Just listen to this few seconds, what he says about the D-Wave machines themselves.
So if you have the opportunity to stand next to one of these machines, it is an awe-inspiring thing, at least for me. It feels like an altar to an alien god. They really are impressive machines.
Okay, he's talking about D-Wave. And now you got the United States bragging on this big, clunky, ancient thing. Believe you me, they are doing things that the average human would just not even know how to process it. But one of the other things that caught me was they named it Summit. That's the name of the computer. Summit is the first supercomputer designed from the ground up to handle machine learning, neural networks, and other AI applications. So they are just moving forward with basically mapping your brain, mapping your DNA, and getting you tied into the system. And that's what they're doing. And of course, like I said, this whole de Blasio thing here, this X, it reminded me of the iPhone, because I was looking at that when it came out. And so I pull up the page. This is the iPhone Apple page, and there's a lot of interesting things here, but what I really noticed was Tuesday the 12th. And now that's when it was released. According to them, the official launch was on September the 11th of last year, and they offered it for $999. Okay, the X 666, remember Apple back in the day, okay? They just sold one of their old computers for a couple million bucks or something like that. But listen to what this lady has to say. She's just telling you about the auctioned off Apple old computer.
Far cry from the $666.66 it sold for back in 1976.
Ah, 1976. Again, very important. 1776. The 7 and the 6 are the 13. The rebellion. I'm telling you. I'm sorry, folks, but this country, United States, was started by very high-level Freemasons. And they're probably good guys, you know? But I'm just telling you, that's what they were. And so Trump is having this summit, and this machine is called Summit, right? This is just nuts, you guys. I'm sorry. I can't. I'm just kind of rambling along here at this point because it's that nuts. Trump is having this summit with Kim there in 3 days on the 12th. The phone, the iPhone, has the 12th on it. Where did that go? Yeah, right here. The iPhone has Tuesday the 12th. Not every month has a Tuesday the 12th. You know, June does, but, you know, May didn't. You know what I mean? There's not very many months that have a Tuesday the 12th. So, that's unique. I'm just showing you this stuff because it's real, it's relevant, it just illustrates this satanic spirit that's been at work forever. And, you know, I see it, and I want to show it to you so that you can have a better understanding that you're dealing with something that is not even humanly fathomable to fight on your own. You cannot do it. It's a physical, natural impossibility. It's a spiritual war. And that's where you need to get in the fight. And on the winning team, of course, who is Jesus Christ. Period. Right? So, I just wanted to show you this stuff. How crazy is this, right? CrossFit, 3-2-2. It's just insanity how this stuff comes together. But, I mean, there it is. You know what I'm saying? What do you want me to tell you? Oh, check this out. Why do you think they grounded all the B-1B bombers? This is yesterday, June 8th. The Air Force has grounded the entire fleet. Why is that, you think? They said they'll return to flight as soon as they fix the seat. It's something about the seat, they say, a safety concern. I believe that they're loading these things up with ordnance, if you know what I mean. That's just what I think. Because so much is coming together, there has to be, at the very least, a very powerful spiritual movement, but I believe we'll see it in the natural. I'm actually looking for something to occur in these next few days, in these next couple weeks. I'm pretty doggone certain of it. Just don't know exactly what or exactly when. But it's coming, and it's supposed to come. And when it does, it's going to usher in a very difficult time if you're not in Christ. And that's just a fact. You got to pray you're worthy to escape the things that are coming upon the earth. Okay? And one last thing. I did go and get a random Bible verse after I was seeing all this, looking this morning, and I pulled up Joshua 1:9. Have not I commanded thee, be strong and of good courage? Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee wheresoever thou goest. Right? So I go to Joshua, and I'm reading Joshua 1. That was verse 9. Well, let's go continue through 10. Then Joshua commanded the officers of the people, saying, pass through the host, and command the people, saying, prepare you victuals, for within 3 days ye shall pass over this Jordan, to go and to possess the land which the Lord your God giveth you to possess. 3 days. This is the 9th. The summit is on the 12th. You know what I mean. George Bush, 93rd birthday. It just goes ridiculously deep. And I think you guys pretty much get where I'm going with this. I'm seeing an event. God's working, people. Nothing happens without him allowing it. So this is all his glory. All glory to God. And seek Jesus diligently if you do not know him. Because he's the only way out of this. I hate to tell you. He's the only way. No man. Okay? So, peace and grace to y'all. Any fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,